John Chow here from johnchow.com, and welcome to another episode of Driving with John Chow. Today, I want to talk to you about business cards, and I want to show you the ultimate business cards. Business cards are all about branding, and a lot of people go to extreme measures to make fancy business cards. For example, I've once received a business card cut out of pure titanium. Really, really fancy. Like I believe they cost $5 a piece per business card. $5. So you know, the guy was trying to make an impression, $5 business card. Right? But despite that fancy business card that's made with the same stuff used to make an American Express Black Card, the ultimate business card is not metal. The ultimate business card, matter of fact, the ultimate business card is not really a business card. This is the ultimate business card right here. Without a doubt, this will blow away any business card. This business card explains who I am and positions me as a go-to expert. See, that's what a business card. Business card is supposed to convey your authority, convey your title, convey your name, you know, that. But this does a much better job. Of all the things I've done in my branding effort, writing my own book has elevated my brand the most. See, when you become a published author, your status goes from mere blogger or marketer or whatever. It goes from all that, and it becomes published author. And that title will open an amazing amount of doors for you. Since writing my book, I've been featured on national television. I've been featured in a documentary on CBC television. I've been in a movie about social media and living the dot-com lifestyle. I've been invited to give keynotes to trade shows, a whole bunch of other associations. And I can attribute a lot of that to writing a book. And the reason for that is, well, the number one reason is published author are automatically perceived as a go-to expert. Like, for example, you know, I can say I wrote the book on making money online because I did, see? The book's called Make Money Online. I wrote the book on it. So I can say that. I wrote the book on making money online. But here's the thing. By writing a book on my topic of expertise, I elevate myself above the next blogger who's writing about blogging. Because they don't have a book. I do. And when big news sites like the new local newspapers, National Post, Vancouver Sun, Orange County Register, you know, when they want to write an article that's in my field, see, newspaper and news outlet are not allowed to give opinion. They're supposed to just, you know, give the news. That's, you know, what's the deal. But we all know that news outlets have their own opinion. They are, you know, like the Huffington Post, very, very leaning to the left. Fox News, very, very leaning to the right. So they do have their opinion, but they can't state it because they're just supposed to get the news. So what they do is they will find an expert to give their opinion for them. So this way, it's not their opinion, it's the expert's opinion, but it's the expert kind of agrees with their opinion. You know? When they're searching out for experts to give opinion pieces on, all newspapers and all tier one media, they have a list of Rolodex of all these people that they can contact to give their opinion. They will always give the preference to the person who's written a book. Simply because by writing a book, you are seen as an expert. So when the Vancouver Sun needs an opinion or some kind of quote on something they read about blogging or social media, Twitter, Facebook, that kind of stuff. Chances are, if they're given a choice between calling me or calling the next blogger who has a blog but no book, they will call me every single time. And that's how I get the press coverage. That's how I get the tier one media coverage. And it's a snowball, you know, because I'm covered by media, and because I got tier one media coverage, you know, I'm in a movie, I'm in documentaries and stuff, and that gets elevates my brand even more, so then I get calls to give keynotes, and it's a snowball effect, right? So if you want to have the ultimate business card and elevate your brand above pretty much anyone that's in your field of expertise, write a book. You look at all the experts out there, they all written books. Look at people, yeah, any. You name one expert, one person who's considered an expert in the field, they have a book. You cannot find anyone. Even Donald Trump has a book, amazingly enough. And actually, and while we're talking about Donald Trump, here's the key. Writing a book may seem like a very, very daunting task, but the truth of the matter is, there's no rule that says you have to write it. See, Donald Trump did not write a single one of his books. They were all ghostwritten. In fact, Robert Kiyosaki, Rich Dad, Rich Dad Poor Dad, he didn't write a single one of his books. You never notice that, look at any one of Robert Kiyosaki's books, Rich Dad Poor Dad book, it always say, Robert Kiyosaki with Sharon Lecter. Sharon Lecter wrote the book. If you look at Robert Kiyosaki was just the face of the Rich Dad face, I guess. If you look at my book, it says John Chow with Michael Kwan. Guess who wrote the book? That's right. You see, Michael Kwan is my writer. He's a freelance writer. He's also my staff writer. But I offered him an opportunity. I said, look, I want to write a book, and I can pay you your ghostwriting fee. My name will be, then just be Make Money Online by John Chow. Or if you want, we can share the byline with John Chow with Michael Kwan. And so your name will be on the book. You have the byline. I won't pay you a ghostwriting fee, but we'll split the royalties 50-50. And then you would become a freelance writer who's a published author. So he took that deal. And as a result, you know, his brand has gone up. He's a freelance writer who's written a book for himself, and very few freelance writers actually have their own book. And since then, he's gone on to write other books, and his writing fee has gone up because he has a published work to show for it. So don't think that, oh my God, I'm gonna have to write a book. That's crazy. I can't write a book. No. You can get it ghostwritten by someone else. And all I did for Michael was I gave him my 60 pages of notes from, you know, scribbling in my mind, and I just go, here, make this into 30,000 words, and he did it. And I got a book, and since then I got on to write another book. There's another book now, and by now you kind of figured out I didn't write the second book either. The second book is like almost 60,000 words, it's twice as big. So don't let the fact that, oh, I have to write a book. No, you do not have to write a book, as long as your name's on the book. See, it's like, you don't have to make your own business card. See, the printer makes your business card. The designer designs your business card, et cetera, et cetera. You don't have to do it. Someone else does it. And a book, so I think of a book as a business card. So therefore, I had it designed and created for me, all right? So, and the last thing is, my first book, Make Money Online, was done by a New York-based publisher. And that took like, oh man, I will never do it again. But my second book, I went through Amazon CreateSpace. And that's what I recommend you do. Second book, basically Amazon CreateSpace. You upload a file, the words file. They compose it into a book format. They create a Kindle edition. They give you the book's ISBN number. It goes up on Amazon. And then you can print as many copies as you want. And since you're the author, you get to buy it at the author's price. See, this book here costs like $3, $3. Now, I can go spend $5 each for titanium business cards and pass them out, or I could pass these out, $3. Now picture this. We're at a meetup, there's a guy passing out titanium business cards. I come in there, I pass out these books. what do you think people are gonna keep? People throw away business cards. They don't throw away books. This is the ultimate business card. John Chow from johnchow.com. I welcome your feedback. Please subscribe to my channel. And I will see you guys for the next episode.